So today we're checking out mansions in Detroit, taking a little break from rehab, and gonna take a look around. There's some great tile in the foyer of this house. Quite a bit of character on that door. Some old vinyl tile here, must be some hardwood floor or something under it. And into this room, you can see it's a sunroom with green Slavic pottery tile and this tile fountain here built into the wall. It's really, so see the ceilings are pretty intricate. Sculpted moldings and carved, and it's actually a barrel vault. Butler's pantry here. All these walls have original tile up into that archway. And then what's the remains of a newer kitchen that's long been scrapped out, but even here, all kinds of tile all around the walls. In the living room of this house, some really great windows, and a pretty impressive fireplace. And once again, some really impressive moldings around the ceiling. And some very thin strips on the hardwood floor, which I'm sure would clean up pretty good with a good amount of effort. Great vintage pink tiled bathroom. It's really something. Complete with the borders and everything, tiled all the way around the window. And the tile window seat. I'm sure there was a nice pedestal sink there at one point. And a tiled shower to boot. Third level, I'm assuming this probably was a servant's quarters or something. We've got terrazzo floor in the bathroom with a little marble inlay. It's really some pretty impressive windows. We're at another house here on Longfellow. Right down the street from Henry Ford's house back in the day. 888. So let's take a look here. Looks like the front steps are relatively intact compared to some of them. Got an old wooden porch. Looks like the brick's pretty solid. Once again, a nice mosaic tile entrance. Well, this house is almost move-in ready. It's missing its radiators and could use some window rehab, but most of the woodwork has never been painted. It's got original built-ins. Floors are in good shape. One very minor roof leak, but other than that, it's great. Yeah, this is the closest to move-in ready I think I've seen in one of these land bank houses, but the backyard, on the other hand, has got quite a bit of cleanup to do, but at least it's outside. As you can see, the old garage took a tumble one night. It looks like they had an additional garage built out in front of their garage. So, you'd have to haul away this giant pile, but you'd get a really nice house, minus the heating system, for a pretty good price, depending on what the auction goes for. Looks like there's a tree to cut down here, too. Some stairs to rebuild, but compared to some of them. Looks like we're missing some balusters on this one. What do you think? Was this the kitchen? Ooh, nice paneling here in this dining room, though. Missing a ceiling, but floors in this house are really in relatively good shape until you get to the sunroom here and notice there's a nice drop off into the crawl space. Still has its radiator in the living room, at least. I'll go outside and show you a quick little shot of the outside on the video. So really some beautiful houses in this area.
Beautiful school down there.
Right?
Elementary. Loving elementary.
Front steps are in good shape, considering, compared to most. Oh yeah, really a great Slavic pottery tile fireplace up in the master suite. Still has its radiators. Needs its floors, but lots of wood floors missing in here. Nice tile in the bathroom. A really nice porte cochere over here. A little bit of repair work to do, but still salvageable. Stucco repair work. needs its ceiling. Ooh, and of course the obligatory vinyl siding on the rear addition. Man, that needs to go. What a shame. Nice house hiding under there though. And really kind of a cute little old garage hiding away back here. The best thing this house has going for it is the Arden Park neighborhood.